Welcome back to Programming with Qt and QML. We are at the second video of this small module here on animations. In the previous video, we saw how we saw the general framework of animation. And in this video here, we're going to see one particular animation kind, namely the path animation. Let me be honest with you, you're not going to use path animation every single day, but it might be the right tool for a specific problem that you have. So let's see what it looks like. You'll notice a rocket flying around in space here in infinite loops. And the setup for this is set up using a path animation. We target our animation, as we saw in the previous video, on that rocket here. We got two lines, we'll get back to those in just a second. And then we set up the path, which is a property of my path animation. That's how I specify which path the rocket should fly along. It starts at this position up here, which is 100 comma and then half down the screen. Then I have a bezier curve to the point x comma y here that is 100 pixels from the right and again halfway down the screen. C1 and C2 that you see here is my control point for setting up this bezier, or as I like to say it, this bizarre curve. I have another path cubic here that goes the other way around for this infinite loop, and together this creates the path that the rocket must fly. Let's start the example in QTopia so we can see the few missing things, what they do in here. That was the wrong example. Let me just start again here. Start the example in Qt Creator here. And now with the right example, and as you can see, the rocket is rotating with its nose first, or it's flying with its nose first, as you would expect a rocket to actually do. If I comment out these two lines here, you will see what they do. Now you will notice that my rocket is flying around, this time not with the nose first, but it's flying sideways through space, and that's of course not how rockets fly. Besides, it's also off the curve, and both of these are explained, of course, with these two things. So, first of all, which of the orientation path animation the top first tells me which point on the rocket that needs to be rotated flown around first. And then the second part here tells me the anchor point. It tells me which point in the rocket I'm talking about. So my rocket width, the width of my rocket, so halfway in through my rocket, halfway down through my rocket. So here is my rocket, and it's the center point of the rocket that is flying around on this curve. Had I not had that one, it would have been the top of my rocket that would have been flying around, and it would visually have looked like I was off the half of the size of the rocket. The last part of this code here is actually just for helping me visualize the bezier curve. I got my rectangle here, I got the text, and let me just run the example again. You can see I got a small rectangle up here and the text C1, and over here C1 marked and C2 and C2 marked. And the last trick is this code that we got here. This code sets up our path view. The path view is from the model view. We haven't talked about that. It's coming in a few videos. But it's a view that will generate me the delegate here a number of times. And exactly how many times? Well, there's going to be 100 small white rectangles that has a size 2x2. And yeah, they are white. And the key thing is they're going to follow this path that I specified with part one here. That was the path all the way up here. That's the path cubic that I set up here. So let me run it again. You can see, you can count for yourself. There's going to be 100 small white rectangles here and 100 red rectangles here so that I can see the actual bezier curve. We got another we got another element inside of QML that's called a path interpolator. And the path interpolator, you can use that class whenever the animation is not cutting it for you. It gives you more control of the actual elements being animated, namely X, Y, and the angle. And it looks like this. I got a rectangle here. The rectangle is black, and let me just run the example so you can see it here. Got a black rectangle inside it. It got this white curve going around there. That is set up with the canvas. Read up on that yourself, how the canvas looked like. Here is my image being animated. But instead of actually animating the image down here, I just set up the path for this. And I run a number animation that takes 3 seconds for the animation to run all the way through. It loops 10 times and it runs from 0 to 1. And that's the progress parameter that I update here. So if you want to have your animation run on some different schedule than just a linear running from one end to the other, then you can set up another animation that runs on progress. It will run along whatever path you set up here. And then the key thing is that the thing that you animate, in this situation, the image, you bind the X, Y, and rotation element to what you have here. And again, you can see my rocket is rotated 90 degrees here. The 90 degrees is so that it points in the right direction. It doesn't fly around this way here, but instead flies around like with the nose first. The other thing that you set up here is X and Y, and the X and Y is set up so that it's the center or the nose of the rocket. It's not the nose of the rocket. I get confused about that all the time. It is the center of the rocket that is on the path that we're animating. Whew. I made it through the path element. That was likely the hardest video for me to record because the path animation is one of those that you use very seldomly. So maybe it told that it's not like sitting at the tip of my tongue as many of the other things we're talking about. The next video is gonna be about another element that isn't exactly animation. It's called a flippable. Try saying that 10 times in a row. The flippable element is this element that can flip around, or it can flip around like this or in other fancy way. It doesn't fit in entirely with animation, but on the other hand, it doesn't fit in anywhere really. So that's what we're gonna see next. Until then, have a great time.